Heel for the Lady Secret Stakes, sent on their way. Zenyatta hesitated just momentarily and lost about a length. Hysterical Lady wants that early lead, and Hysterical Lady will kick on to lead them early. Super Freaky's right there in second. Santa Teresita moves up on the outside. Not any particular hurry out here, and Zenyatta quite content just to track the other trio. They run past the 7/8 and Hysterical Lady now got her ears pricked, just takes them along a steady pace, leads it by a length. Santa Teresita is on the far side and Super Freaky trucked in third. And Zenyatta got herself a little closer now. She's back fourth, but only 3.5 off the leader. Onto the backstretch they go. All riders appear happy with their situation. Probably not going to be much of a change. Hysterical Lady at a sensible pace. Nice hold she's taken as well. Leads it by one length. Santa Teresita right there second, and Super Freaky down at the rail. And still the trailer Zenyatta, but they very bunched now. There's only three lengths covering them all. Half mile to go in the Lady's Secret and Hysterical Lady now. Gomez just takes a peep back to see where the others are. Right there, Santa Teresita. Down at the rails, Super Freaky. And now Zenyatta starts to make her run on the outside. A little early, 3/8 pole. She's asked to go after them now. They're approaching the quarter pole. Hysterical Lady, Santa Teresita up alongside of that. Zenyatta's taking a little time to come and tackle them. Super Freaky down at the rails. Three lengths covers them all. Heads are turned for home in the Lady's Secret. Hysterical Lady, Santa Teresita, and now Zenyatta straightens up, and here comes Zenyatta yet again, just a tap on the shoulder, ears pricked. She's just looking at the other three and striding away effortlessly. 8/8 for Zenyatta, a champion's effort. She romps
second. Well, once she straightened out for home, it was all over. Zenyatta 8/8.
She just rolls down the center of the track. This is a very, very easy performance. Her ears are pricked there. I mean, she's got a lot left in the tank. I guarantee, if you ask Mike Smith, this filly wasn't even out of third gear this afternoon. She will be a heavy, heavy favorite in the Ladies' Classic.
Moving into line, and here comes Zenyatta with Hall of Famer Mike Smith. The show starts right now. It is the Grade One Ladies' Secret featuring the champion, Zenyatta. Good luck and enjoy.
And away they go. All came out smoothly. Breecat is going straight to the front. Made for Magic along the inside. And Narva's Creation, taking a nice hold, is going to settle in the third spot with Lethal Heat right there. Cocoa Beach is pretty keen to go on down at the rail. And then we drop back here to Life is Sweet and Zenyatta's. And Zenyatta's a lot closer today. Zenyatta's no more than 5 off this leader. They head to the three-quarter pole, and Bree Cat got her ears pricked out here. She's not flying, just takes them along a length and a half in front of Made for Magic. And Narva's Creation, nice and comfortable in third, and Cocoa Beach is down at the rail in fourth. Then back to Lethal Heat, fifth. He's 5 lengths off the leaders. It's another 2 to Zenyatta, and let's see, she's just loping along here. Mike Smith just got her on a long range. She's pricking her ears back and forth. Zenyatta's now 6 off the leader as they take closer order, and Life is Sweet as the trailer. They have a half mile to go in the Lady's Secret, and the long shot Bree Cat still sets the pace out here, being followed by Made for Magic. Cocoa Beach is right there third, and Arbor's Creation fourth. Lethal Heat is now 5 off that leader. And let's see, here's Zenyatta. Mike Smith asking her to pick it up now, and Zenyatta is 6 off the leader, starting to close. Life is Sweet as last. They are coming to the top of the lane in the Lady's Secret, and Bree Cat under pressure now. Another long shot Made for Magic right there. And here's Zenyatta now. She's winding away between horses and now going to come to the outside. And Mike Smith takes dead aim on the leaders and asks Zenyatta to go. And just look at her go. Zenyatta strikes the front, just playing with him here. Ears going back and forth. And it's Zenyatta, Lethal Heat running on at the rail. But Zenyatta with condescending ease wins it only a length, but so easily.
Personal ensign. You got some company, sister. But it's the kind of company that you like. It's royalty. It's the queen. It is Zenyatta, who matches that mark 13/13, and she does it in emphatic style.
Forward this time. Going in. Last one, Awesome Gem. Awesome Gem's in. They're all set for the $5 million Breeders' Cup Classic. Feels sent on their way in the Breeders' Cup Classic to the roar of the Santa Anita crowd. Regal Ransom bounced away quickly. Zenyatta is dead last. Zenyatta's dead last early. It's Regal Ransom going on. Giofonti, Einstein is right there. Colonel John in the white colors. Summerbird has the red cap in the vanguard too. Rip Van Winkle is on the outside and twice over racing right behind them. They tightly grouped and not in a big hurry out on the lead. Then it's Awesome Gem. Giofonti's back fourth last. Been followed then by Richard's Kid. Then comes Mind That Bird, and Zenyatta is dead last. Zenyatta last, got to be giving them about 10, 11 length start. They grudge the three-quarter pole now in the Classic, and it's Regal Ransom just setting a sensible pace, not in a big hurry out here. Rip Van Winkle now goes up second, and Colonel John scrapes the paint in third. Einstein's right there too. Girolamo, white cap, far side. Here's Ken DeSormo on Summerbird. They six at the rail, just five off the leader. Then it comes twice over, Awesome Gem, and Giofonti's giving them seven length start. Then it's Richard's Kid. Now here's Zenyatta. Zenyatta is still a good 10, 11 off the leaders. And then it's four back to Mind That Bird. A half mile to go now in the Classic, and still the leader is Regal Ransom, a length and a half. Rip Van Winkle being sent along after him, then Colonel John. On the far side, Girolamo. Einstein is right there. Summerbird at the rail. Twice over is next. Then Awesome Gem. Giofonti's behind that. Then Richard's Kid. And now here's Zenyatta. And let's see. Zenyatta has a lot of ground to make up. Zenyatta, if she wins this, she'll be a super horse. She's starting to pick them off, though. Zenyatta going to hook to the outside. Meanwhile, it's Colonel John. Summerbird in the red cap. Look out, Zenyatta's coming. Giofonti on the inside, Summerbird is right there. This is unbelievable! Zenyatta, what a performance, one we'll never forget. Looked impossible, but it is Zenyatta, still unbeaten under Mike Smith. Giofonti second, Summerbird, and then Richard's Kid. What a dramatic performance, one of the most sensational ever. Zenyatta wins the Breeders' Cup Classic.
You can never ride a horse where they don't want to go, so the horse takes you.
But you better take a look at Zenyatta to run by.
Zenyatta took us places we never imagined we could go.
When she first came in from Genie's after about 6 weeks, John took someone, a friend, over to the stall and said, "This is my Michael Jordan if I can get her right."
Here's a future superstar, Zenyatta.
And we got her, he got her right.
And Zenyatta, just an amazing coverage of ground. She just covers so much ground with those bounding strides.
Literally after the El Encino, when she won, he leaned over and whispered in my ear, "Who's gonna ever beat her?"
This is Zenyatta. Zenyatta.
And Zenyatta just making it look all too easy.
When this happens, it's just elation, you know, it's joy.
I've never asked her to do more than she's had to.
Riding away effortlessly, 8 for 8.
She's used to having her picture taken, having people make a big fuss over her, and then that's it. It's the same ending. 14 endings, all the same. Incredible.
Here's the real Zen Master, and she's won 11!
The beautiful thing about her is once she got in gear, She was allowed to circle the field many times because she dominated the field so much.
And probably the race that she gets the least credit for, but I thought was one of her better races, was the Clement Hirsch at Del Mar, where she was looked like she didn't have a chance.
Zenyatta!
Fortunately, I wasn't close to the wire, so I didn't know she was running out of racetrack.
So close, I think Zenyatta got up in those.
Track has said she was going 40 miles an hour at the finish. I mean, that's just amazing.
Her game, if you could read into that beautiful mind of hers, you know, is to win the race, you know. It didn't matter to her how much she won it by. She wanted to just win.
And just look at her go!
She just seems bottomless.
Zenyatta strikes the front, just playing with him here. He is going back and forth.
They're just gears after gears after gears, you know, and I never get to all of them.
And she's having such a good time doing it, so you think there's got to be some magic in that, because she's posing and she's dancing and she's never exhausted herself. She was still dancing in the winner's circle afterwards, so it feels good.
Feels safe on their way in the Breeders' Cup. traffic to the roar of the Santa Anita crowd.
The way she captured everybody's imagination, and here she is, center stage, all the pressure of the world on her, you know, a million reasons or a dozen reasons for her not to perform at her utmost on Saturday.
Zenyatta is dead last. Zenyatta's dead last early.
And then, you know, she pulls it all together and runs her race, and it was like it was no big deal to her.
Zenyatta has a lot of ground to make up. Zenyatta, if she wins this, she'll be a super horse.
Once I hit the outside, and the crowd let out this big roar.
Zenyatta gonna hook to the outside.
She hit three or four jumps like she always does, and by the field, and it'll come the years again.
You know, there's like a moment where you're just kind of, did this really happen moment.
But it is Zenyatta, still unbeaten under Mike Smith.
The next day or so, I ran into a friend of mine that, as a director, and he congratulated me on the race, and he said, you know, I don't know anything about racing, but I do know show business, you know. And that was fantastic show business. You know?
And when I stepped onto the racetrack and the crowd was cheering and applauding her and crying, it was just a magical moment for me. Threw my cap into the crowd because, you know, at that particular moment, I was probably ready to burst.
Everything that's good about the sport crossed that finish line at that moment.
We needed something spectacular, something way over the top, something that we've never seen. And she was all of that and more.
I don't know if, you know, winning 14 races in a row is, it's hard to imagine that. It's hard to really look back and fathom how she pulled that off.
Perfection. You know, it's, she couldn't be any better, you know. She's done everything we've asked her to do.
Zenyatta means to me the most unbelievable thing that's ever happened to me in my life, most unbelievable horse.
She is glorious. She has wings. You know, it was like one of those great enchanted moments in life. Well, she's a gift. She's an enormous gift.
I honestly believe she could beat anybody. I really do. I think she's unbeatable. That's what she means to me.